Namaste, welcome to the session Design of Multiplexer Tree. At the end of this session, students will be able to design a multiplexer tree. In this session, we are going to design a multiplexer tree. Now, before proceeding further, take a pause here and recall what do you mean by multiplexer. So, multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit which selects binary information from 2^n number of input lines using n number of selection, or also known as a control inputs, and directs it to the single output line. Multiplexer is also known as data selector. Now let us see block diagram of n:1 multiplexer. So here you can see there are 2^n data inputs, and where n number of select or control inputs are there, and one output data line. So from this block diagram, we can observe that there are 2^n data inputs, n number of control inputs, are also known as select inputs, and one data output line. Now let us see advantages of multiplexer. Using multiplexer, it is easy to design a combinational logic circuit, because whenever you are designing a combinational logic circuit, sometimes it is required to minimize the equation of the combinational logic circuit using K-map or other technique. But whenever you are designing a combinational logic circuit using multiplexer, there is no need to minimize the logical equation. It is also easy to debug a circuit which is designed using multiplexer. Now, disadvantage of multiplexer is that if number of inputs are more to a combinational logic circuit, then circuit becomes very large if designed using multiplexer. Now, let us design a multiplexer circuit. Now, for example, we are going to design a 4:1 multiplexer. Before drawing a block diagram, so we need to know how many inputs are there. From number of inputs, we can find out number of select inputs required. So according to the equation, 2^m is equal to n, where m is number of select inputs and n is number of data inputs. So if number of inputs are 4, then select inputs required, that is m, is 2. So for n is equal to 4 data inputs, we require m is equal to 2 select inputs. So let us draw the block diagram here. So here the data inputs are represented by letter I. So 4 inputs are I0, I1, I2, I3. And let us consider letter S for select inputs as S1 and S0. Along with these inputs, we have one more input, that is enable input, denoted as E, which is used to start or stop the operation of multiplexer. And then we have one output represented as F. Now the second step is to write a truth table. So we know that for 4:1 multiplexer, we have two select inputs or control inputs as S1 and S0, and four data inputs as I0, I1, I2, I3, F as an output, and E as an enable input. So for this block diagram, we have this truth table, where we have indicated enable input as active high. So whenever enable input is 0, none of the input is get selected or are disabled. So we are getting output F as 0. So when enable input is 1, now let us consider 4 inputs I0, I1, I2, I3, maybe 0 or 1, as binary inputs are given, and consider enable input as 1. So when select input S1 and S0 are 0, 0, then I0 will be get selected. So I0 may be 0 or 1. So accordingly, output will also 0 or 1. So whenever S1 and S0 are 0, I0 will be get selected, and that is connected to the output. So output may be 0 or 1. When S1 is 0 and S0 is 1, then I1 should get selected, and according to the I1 value, whether it may be 0 or 1, we are getting output as 0 or 1. So here only I1 is get selected and that is connected to the output. Now similarly, when S1 and S0 are 1, 0 respectively, then I2 is get selected and then it is connected to output line. When S1 and S0 both are 1, 1, then I3 is get selected and depending upon value of I3, output will be 0 or 1. So whenever both are 1, 1, we are getting output selected from the I3. Now after truth table, we are writing logical equation for 4:1 multiplexer. So from this truth table, we can observe that we are getting I0 selected when both S1 and S0 are 0, 0. So here equation becomes I0 into S1 bar, S0 bar plus the I1 is get selected when S1 is 0 and S0 is 1. So here the equation becomes I1 S1 bar S0 plus I2 is get selected when S1 is 1 and S0 is 0. So I2 S1 S0 bar plus I3 will be get selected here when S1 and S0 both are 1, 1. So equation becomes I3 S1 S2 and enable is 1, so into E. So this is logical equation for 4:1 multiplexer. In the next step, we are going to draw logic circuit for 4:1 multiplexer. So here you can observe the circuit is drawn according to the equation. Now let us design multiplexer tree. So what is a multiplexer tree? A larger multiplexer can be implemented using a tree of smaller multiplexers. So when we are designing 4:1 multiplexer using 2:1 multiplexer, we require 3 2:1 multiplexer and we require 2 select inputs. Let us see how. So here you can see in the first row we have 2 multiplexers which are having 2 inputs each and output of these first 2 multiplexers are given to third 2:1 multiplexers as a input. So here you can see the first multiplexer having I0 I1 input, second 2:1 multiplexer having I2 I3 input and third 2:1 multiplexer having input which are the output from the first 2:1 multiplexers. So first 2:1 multiplexer having common select input as S0 and third one having select input or control input as S1. Now let us see how it works. Now let us consider S1 and S0 both are 0, 0 where S1 is MSB. So when S0 is 0, so I0 and I2 will be get selected and as S1 is 0, first input of the third 2:1 multiplexer it gets selected. So in this way I0 is get selected and that is connected to the output line. Now when S1 is 0 and S0 is 1, as S0 is 1, I1 and I3 are get selected and as S1 is 0, the first input of 2:1 multiplexer is get selected. So here I1 is get selected and that is connected to the output where I3 is not selected. Now when S1 is 1 and S0 is 0, then because of S0 is 0, I0 and I2 is get selected and as S1 is 1, the second input of third 2:1 multiplexer it gets selected. So here you can observe that I2 is get selected and that is connected to the output line. Now when S1 and S0 are both 1, 1, because of S0 is 1, I1 and I3 will be get selected and as S1 is 1, The second input of third 2:1 multiplexer is gate selected. So in this way, I3 is gate selected and that is connected to the output line. So in this way, multiplexer tree works. So let us have one more example, 16:1 multiplexer using 4:1 multiplexer. So in this case, we require 5 numbers of 4:1 multiplexer. And in 16:1 multiplexer, we require 4 select inputs as S1, S0, S2, S3. And 16 inputs as I0 to I15 and F is the output. So here is the block diagram where you can see we have used 4:1 multiplexer in the first row where it is having 16 inputs I0 to I15. And in the first row, 4:1 multiplexer are having 2 select inputs common as S1 and S0. Fifth 4:1 multiplexer where it is having select input as S3 and S2. So in this way you can design any multiplexer tree using smaller multiplexers. These are references. Thank you.